because I grew up underneath that GCN, and it was very, very terrible. I don't even know what to say, but as for those who really know that the global pandemic, this COVID-19, has swept millions of people around the world, but you're lucky that you are still here, right? You have a contribution to have a purpose in life, because you are still here, you're still alive, and you are still healthy. So yeah, guys, I'm contributing this video for you so that you can clearly be able to prepare you for the exam. So I'm going to go through some of the questions that I think are going to pop up in the exam that which is coming in a few days. So guys, don't over prepare this paper, but I suppose it's good to be testing your prior knowledge of micro and macroeconomics, right? So don't over prepare on paper 3. So I want to go through some of the essays that I think that I'm going to pop up. So the first lineup of questions was the basic economic problem, right? This has been a phenomenon all over around the world. The basic economic problem has been some of the essays that I want to ask that you have to understand. So under the basic economic problem, you know what is the basic economic problem. Also talk about the market systems. These are what type of market systems practice in your country. You know, they discuss the cost and benefits of each type of market system that you've been asked in the exam situation. So it's very important for you to understand that, guys. You know that the market system is some of the structures that are going to come in exam questions. And look at the price mechanism. We talked about price mechanism, those four integral functions, the price mechanism, because you know the Russian incentive function is going to be asked, guys. That's actually going to be 2-5 mark question, which you should just be happy with answering that one. So it's actually going to be a very important question there. Then we go to the other question, which is the question of elasticity. This is a question that will be testing you, your prior knowledge of elasticity concept. Do you know the elasticity, four concepts of elasticity? We look at PED, XED, YED, and PES, right? These are some of the concepts that you should know. You should know the business use of each of the elasticity concepts, guys. Go on to a very important question and ask you that, what are the relevant of elasticity concept to a farmer, to a butcher, to a supermarket? You should know the relative, how they are very important to those prior understandings, right? So another thing is that you should understand that we need to know the standards of PED and PES, right? On PED, that's members flat, guys. We've been doing this more advice, guys, on the geometry economics, right? It's time for economy here. We know that I'm your host. There will be none other than me forever, right? So that's what we want to talk about, price versus supply, looking at that, the sound that comes out when you open some kind of a pop like a Pepsi, right? As you know that we are in December, right? We should be enjoying, but this is the year whereby month that you'll be just celebrating that we are still alive, we are still here. But this global pandemic, guys, has been tremendous, right? Again, it has been affecting everything, I tell you, everything. Then another question is on our business, business studies, which is a question that will ask you the government assistance to small firms, or small firms to best sell the save the society, discuss the cost of delivery behind small firms, government assistance to small firms, despite competition from large firms, how do small firms survive? They ask you that question, you should be able to answer that in a long term. That is very important. Then another question is about definition of key economic terms like personal and transfer earnings, like private good, direct good. They will ask you those questions, those economic terms. You should be able to use diagrams. If you know any, you should apply them. It's going to be very useful in the exam situation in paper 3. So this is the paper that is highly recommended so that you can actually pass with flying colors. But this is the paper that holds most of your marks, guys. This paper is 50% weight of a proto exam. So you should be able to nail this paper, guys. It's going to be very important. Let me go to this question of theory distribution. Most of them have seen that theory distribution before, but for the reason I don't clearly understand, was in the step forward question that you come 3-5 months, how is differential justified in your current 3-5 months? You're supposed to just answer it, no problems, no complications there. So it's very important for you to answer that question of wage differential. Then another thing is we want to look at market failure. This is a question that has been much more encompassing, talking about the causes of market failure, how indirect tax solve market failure, how a subsidy will solve market failure. It's going to be a question that's going to be asked in your exam situation. Should we answer that? And also the policy to reduce market failure is going to be a question that I'm feeling that's going to come in exam, so you should be prepared for that. Then the other question is on market structures. This is the structures that are very important, talking about the characteristics of them, how efficient they are in the comparisons. You should be able to compare between previous competition and the monopoly to oligopoly. You should be able to compare those concepts. It's going to be very, very important for you in exam situation. You know that how efficient is previous competition, how can we apply it to our modern day? As for monopoly, we have a lot of questions coming on monopoly. They ask you about price discrimination. They discuss the cost and benefits of price discrimination. You should be able to answer that question. It's going to be very, very important, guys. I see your example. So make sure that you know the question. Then I'll cross it off to macroeconomics. I'm expecting to come to one of the topics that the whole topics that I'm expecting to come is national income. And national income is the topic that is very straightforward. National income accounting, national income statistics, whereby they ask you to define the difference between GDP and GNP, and also methods of measuring national income, the importance of national income statistics. Is a measure of national income. Those are some of the issues that have been conversing on national income statistics. Also, another thing about comparing different standards of living between countries is also going to be a question that I'm feeling that's going to come out. Then, going to other prior topics that have been most popping up in most exam situations, we're talking about inflation, unemployment, and economic growth. These are the topics which have what debate. Topics that are going to be featured in the exam. You should be able to know the causes of them, the cost and benefits of them, and the policies to reduce unemployment, also the policies to promote economic growth, the policies to reduce inflation. You should know those things, because you should understand that, especially the policy question, guys, you should evaluate people to say, well, that is where they ask you, are you a true economist, or are you just doing what you call food economics? That is a good idea, right? So that's how you should understanding those concepts. And another topic that I feel that I know that's going to come is the relationship between economic growth and economic development. This is a crucial relationship between economics or developing economies. And when we talk about what is the relationship between economic growth and economic development, that's another hot debate question that will be coming there. And also the characteristics of developing countries, and also a person that is very calm is going to become economic in some situation. Then another thing is that we have to understand that we have also test expectations of international trade, right? This is a topic that is most students because they don't cover their syllabus well, but this topic is going to be featured in the exam, whereby they ask you the courses and the consequences of current account deficits, also the policies to rectify current account deficits. Should the government worry about current account deficits? No, they discuss the costs and benefits of current account deficits and current account surpluses. What are the evaluation points behind those current account surpluses and current account deficits? Should be able to understand that. Also, they ask you that you have expenditure switching. So they're missing policies. How are you going to apply them to rectify kind of what you said, which the country is facing? So you should clearly understand those concepts and explain them in this video, guys. Again, going to the other side of the of my paper, I wrote the idea of resilient. Oh, guys, resilient, it's a topic most of them find very difficult, but for reasons that I don't even understand. What it's saying is that it's whereby we just compare the value of one currency to another currency. But how it's saying is determined, by force of demand and supply, you should be able to define fixed and floating exchange, being able to compare the two and see which one is better. When you should be able to see what it's saying, the change is the impact, right? On the impact, where will the country want to weaken its exchange rate? Why should the government worry about exchange rate falling in value? Those are some of the issues that you should be discussing, right? Should the government never influence the value of the exchange rate? You should be concerned about that question is going to come. So that's another issue of behind floating and fixed exchange rate, right? Well, what debate is coming then? You should be able to expect it to come and you should be able to narrow it well. Then another thing is about protectionism, guys. Where would the country want to protect its domestic industries, that those infant industries, why would you want to protect them? So you should understand that protectionism is in line with the idea of protecting infant industries, allowing them to grow to the international level that they want to be cooperative. Looking at analyze the effects of using tariffs and quotas, what are the major issues behind using tariffs and quotas, right? Then you talk about trade and protectionism, the link between trade and protectionism, what are the issues behind those things? That is another word to get easy. That's going to pop up in the exam day. The other thing that I'm feeling that's going to come is the issue of foreign aid and development. You know that in this case, foreign aid was coming to this developing country due to the global pandemic, like this COVID-19, where every aid is coming in Zimbabwe. So this is another exam question that we are going to come. What are analyze the implications behind it? A country developing through policies of aid, relying on aid for development. So they ask you, is it necessary for developing countries to rely on trade, right? To rely on aid that is coming from other countries? So they will ask that question, you should be able to name it. The other thing is about the distribution of income and wealth, right? What are some of the unfair labor markets? What is the policies that are needed to redistribute income and wealth in the economy? So that's some of the issues behind the distribution of progressive taxes, the Lafarge argument. what you are saying, that if you charge higher taxes up until a minimum efficient point, then it takes every year before it starts to fall. That's what I was talking about, the idea that entrepreneurs no longer want to be productive because you're taking a lot of money from them, right? So that's another whole debate topic that you're expecting. The other topic is about reducing policy to reducing income inequality. This is another topic that I'm just feeling like it's going to feature in exams, so being expected to answer that question. Then we go to the other side where we look at policies, guys. These are the very crucial important thing about macroeconomics, right? Whereby they ask you how do central banks set interest rates, and how monetary policy works, and how fiscal policy works, and how supply side policy works. Should be able to deal with them purely without any complications, right? Should be able to explain them. Then you go to the last topic on my list here about the expectations of the is about economic integration. Arguments against economic integration, the customs union, the free trade. What are the other issues behind the benefits of doing free trade, right? The customs union, the common market, right? This is the economic integration. The COMESA and those kind of examples, the Atlantic region. What are the what they say about those things about economic integration? What is it kind of a phenomenon of most developing countries like in all around the world? So guys, these are the expectations that I have for you writing paper 3 exams, guys. So it's going to be very exciting, right? So I'm going to name it, guys. And I want you guys to relax, guys. Just relax, guys. It's not the time to over prepare your paper 3, guys. You know that the primary that you have of micro and macro is enough for you to write an exam. Once the way I see it, I produced videos, I produced PDFs for you guys. Just go and read those things. Just go through those PDFs. That's what is going to be asked on those videos. That's going to watch those videos, and it's going to be very exciting, right? So thank you so much for joining for economics. Time for economics has been exciting. I'm very excited that you're going to make me proud of this exam. And I'm really excited that it's also coming to my end. So I'm kind of worried that, but I know that it's going to be just exciting. So make sure that you wear your mask always, but the global pandemic is also going to be an issue, but either way, but we have been having a good journey, guys. So thank you so much for watching this video. I'm hoping everyone that is watching this video, you'll be very excited to write an exam, and salute. I'll see you. Good night.